الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد، يا أيها الذين آمنوا اجتنبوا كثيرا من الظن إن بعض الظن إثم، ولا تجسسوا ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا ولا يغتب بعضكم بعضا أيحب أحدكم، واحد فيكم يعني، أن يأكل لحم أخيه ميتا فكرهتموه، والنتيجة فاتقوا الله. اتقوا الله في الظن، واتقوا الله في عدم التجسس، واتقوا الله في الغيبة. ومن أبشع التشبيه الدال على الحرمة أن الغيبة تشبه أكل لحم أخيك وهو ميت، تكره ذلك طبعا وتكره ذلك شرعا لحرمته. This ayah talks about ghibah, which is backbiting. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us an example, like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sometimes he gives us examples so we get the meaning and we can relate to it. And if the meaning is hidden a little bit, it clarifies it. It makes you think, makes you reflect. It's not like giving you the order halal or haram versus comparing it to something you can relate to it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you have a brother who is dead. How would you feel if someone tells you take a bite? Enjoy eating his flesh. Disgusting. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, backbiting is just as disgusting. Eating him, his flesh dead, is haram also. Backbiting is haram too. So you have disgusting and haram. This is how you should think when you talk about someone behind his back. And remember, you're saying things as is. You're not lying. It happened. He said it. The only difference is he doesn't like you to talk about it. So you're not lying. So don't think just because you're telling it as it is, it's not backbiting. Because some people will talk and say, wallahi brother, I'm not lying, this is what happened. Yeah, well, this is exactly what backbiting is. It's what happened. Would you talk in his face what you told me? If you do, not as a challenge, it's like, yeah, I'm not a mishkaif. If you do, like, yes, you talk, and he's not going to get upset, then it's not backbiting. And if you start backbiting, and you add that statement before you start, inshallah, this is not backbiting, know for sure you're backbiting. Because you will not say that unless you have doubt that you are backbiting. But you know, Sheikh, if you don't backbite, what are we going to talk about? Tell me. Wallah, Sheikh. انت تفضل يا شيخ وبحر فيه وعندك حال يا وري انا توك اباوت شو ممكن يعني انسان يتكلم اذا ما في شيء ديبي nothing صح اذا when we sit in a gathering and we start talking religion don't say oh sheikh you always talk about religion what else you want to talk about backbiting Or if you don't talk something pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're going to get involved in something displeasing. And that's why we try anywhere you go to bring a topic that's relating to the religion. It could be Quran, it could be Hadith, it could be just regular talk about religion, to avoid backbiting and to make the conversation enjoyable. If talking about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not enjoyable to you, then obviously you're so poisoned with sins, you only like to talk about sins. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He said, أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيْتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُوهُ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. سفيان الثوري, مين بعرف سفيان الثوري؟ انت بتعرفه صح. سفيان الثوري ما شاء الله, one of the great تابعين, he told his friends, قال لأصحابه, قال لو أن فيكم رجلا, لو أن فيكم رجلا يرفع كلامكم إلى السلطان, أكنتم تتكلمون فيما يغضبه؟ يعني يغضب السلطان؟ قالوا لا, ومن منا يجرؤ على ذلك. سفيان الثوري رضي الله عنه, he wants to show them what backbiting effect is and how dangerous it is. So he asked him a question that we all can relate to. He said, if there is someone sitting in your circle that is fine, everything you say, he's going to pass it to the ruler. Are you, or will you talk about something the ruler doesn't like? They said, no, who dares to do that? قال فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ فِيكُمْ مَلَائِكَ يَرْفَعُونَ أَقْوَالَكُمْ إِلَى اللَّهِ فَأَحْسِنُوا كَلَامَكُمْ وتكلموا فيما تحبوا أن يعرض عليكم أو يعرض على ربكم عندما تلقونه. So he said, well, know for sure that you have angels sitting with you. They're going to take your conversation and pass it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So make sure you speak good things. يعني أحسنوا في كلامكم, and speak what you like to see presented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فإحنا بنخاف من السلطان ولا نخاف الله سبحانه وتعالى. أتخشونه فالله أحق أن تخشوا إن كنتم مؤمنين. يعني إن لم تفعلوا ذلك, إن لم تخشوا الله أكثر مما تخشون السلطان أو الناس, فأنتم لستوا بمؤمنين كاملي الإيمان. الله سبحانه وتعالى said, do you fear them, referring to people or to the enemy? Fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى more if you are a believer. Meaning if you fear people more than Allah سبحانه, if you worry about people, you don't speak but good, and you're not worrying about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you're making yourself similar to the people. When Prophet Lut alayhi salam, what did he say? He said, شو قال يا شيخ حسين؟ الآية بعطيك شوي منها إذا ما جبتهاش. واتخذتموه وراءكم ظهريا, شو بدايتها؟ يلا وين الحفاظ؟ Brother Nabil, that's not Hifad, that's Google. What's the beginning? هم شو قالوا؟ ولولا رهتك لرجمناك. وما أنت علينا
بعزيز.
شو؟
مثل شعيب مطلوب.
طيب شعيب الله يرضى عليك كمل الآية.
قالوا أرحتك، قال أرحتي أعز.
هاي بعرفها شيخ اللي بعدها. ياس ينضحك، احنا صرنا ساعتين نص ساعة حبيبي نحكي اللي حكيتها قلت لي إياها، بس أعطيتني معلومة كويسة جاية جزاك الله خيرا. شعيب رئيس قوم لوط. قال أرهتي أعز عليكم من الله واتخذتموه وراءكم ظهريا. They told him, hadn't it been for your tribe, we would have stoned you or expelled you. He said, my people are more dearer to you than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You put his orders behind your back, يعني you ignored his orders. And I say the same thing. When you backbite, if your backbiting is going to be to someone with power going to stop you, but to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to stop you, you have a problem. You need to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his due greatness. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Nuh, قال وانت بس بتطلع علي اذا بيحكي لك شغله شو قال؟ فقلت استغفروا ربكم انه كان غفارا. ما شاء الله. يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم باموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم انهارا. ما لكم لا ترجون لله وقارا. شو مشكلتكم؟ ما في عندكم احترام ولا تعظيم لله سبحانه وتعالى ولا لأوامر الله. وقد خلقكم أطوارا كما تعلمون. شو هي الأطوار؟ من نطفة ثم من علقة ثم من مضغة ثم يخرجكم طفلة ثم لتبلغوا أشدكم. يعني الله سبحانه وتعالى is saying, what's wrong with you? Why aren't you giving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his due respect and greatness? And you know how he created you, the stages you went through. يعني look at yourself, how tiny, trivial you are, and how great Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you're not even realizing that. اللي بيعرف ضعفه بيعرف قوة الله سبحانه وتعالى، واللي بيعرف فقره بيعرف غنى الله سبحانه وتعالى. When you know how poor you are, you know how rich Allah سبحانه وتعالى is. And when you know how weak you are, you know how strong Allah سبحانه وتعالى is. So, conclusion حبيبي, don't backbite. Make all of your gathering remembrance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى in any way. Because if you don't, trust me, it's I heard and he heard, and he said and she said, and we did and they did, and they should and we would. It's always someone else you're talking and you think you're advising. Like you start criticizing decisions of the people, for example. And what are you doing? Nothing. Did you help anything? No. Did you fix it? No. Where is your expertise? In backbiting, mashallah. You're an expert in backbiting. But in real life, useless. Be an expert in obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakumullahu khairan. Brother, it's only 1 minute. I said it's the last minute. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Sure.